question.
But you know what? It's not very different from the same story that's developing with the Smith and Wesson folks that are selling handguns and AK-47s and every other thing that you can buy nowadays just at your local gun store. They're bragging about the fact that mass killings are good for them. I mean, literally saying, trying to tell their shareholders, this is the greatest thing in the world. Once children are mowed down with an AK-47, once women are gunned down in their building because some nut with a gun has access to them, once that happens, gun sales increase, and that is really good for us.
It is. You know, we see these stories, you know, a shooter goes in with an AK-47 and slaughters 20 people. Then you get this, again, the reactive nature of Americans is, oh, well, he's got an AK-47. I got to go buy two AK-47s so that I can be the good guy with a gun that doesn't exist in real life, by the way, regardless of what the Republicans want to tell us. And so the gun industry, again, they love mass shootings, and they always have, because it means more gun sales, because they sell fear.
They asked their little puppet, Ted Cruz, right after San Bernardino, right after people were slaughtered, they asked the little Cruz creep to show up and have a gun rally. And he does that. And the money that he gets for doing that is coming directly from the gun industry. Smith & Wesson says, yeah, we really love this Cruz creep, because after all these people are mowed down, killed, murdered with our guns, he's going to have a gun rally and he's going to sell more guns for us. And we saw that unfold. If I were to tell you that we're going to that was going to happen, you'd say that's so remote. It's so crazy. Not anymore, because it actually happened, where this freak shows up and has a gun rally right after this mass killing.
And we've seen that with several other Republicans across the country. One of them had just sent out a Christmas card with his entire family, including kids, you know, about 6 or 7 years old, everyone holding these assault rifles. And that's their Christmas card, because that's all they know. This is going to get me some votes. It's going to get me some gun industry money in my campaign. And it's sickening that they are so obsessed with guns, because that's their substitute, just like it is with Ted Cruz, for masculinity. Because that's all they have. I mean, they're absolute cowards. They're weak. You know, it's sickening.
Well,
but that's
okay.
Exactly, what it is.
Let's back up just a little bit. You hit on something I think you got to talk about a little bit. There are so many studies that have been done that talk about what is the mindset of the reactionary. Who is the guy who feels like he needs a gun, you know, grows the goatee, drives the big, you know, the big Humvee, drives the big truck, bad cat is what he's trying to portray. You've seen it. I mean, you know, you go on. It's the Bruce Willis look. It's the Bruce Willis mentality. Who are these people? And they've done study after study to say they are the most fearful people. Within a group of 10, you can point them out as being the most fearful people in that group. They're afraid. Everything's uncertain. Everything to them is very, very, it's a very scary world. So you see this reaction a couple of ways. You see it, A, they're going to carry the gun because it makes them feel, as you point out, like they're more in control of their lives, because they're fearful that they're not. And B, it builds into that persona that the gun industry has been trying to pitch, the same way the cigarette industry tried to pitch the Marlboro Man. So this is where we are with this right now. And the studies, you know, if you're one of these people, you should be embarrassed. You should be humiliated when you read these studies of what it says about you.
Well, you know, it's just funny, because you said it a lot nicer than I would have. But I think Ted Cruz, as you had pointed out, Ted Cruz perfectly embodies that entire mindset of the, you know, weak individual who portrays himself as this strong character, when in reality, he is terrified of everything, terrified of change, terrified of anyone who's not an elderly white man, terrified that they're not in control of their own lives or their own destiny. And Ted Cruz is the Republican candidate that perfectly embodies that.
And there's another part of it. Ted Cruz is the same Jeb. You know, he's the same Jeb Bush. He's the same Donald Trump. Donald Trump hid during the Vietnam conflict. Ted Cruz has never picked up a gun and actually had to be in a battle before. Little Jeb, Jeb got all kinds of passes to ever serve anywhere. You could go right down the list. And all of these characters, Rubio, did he ever show up in Iraq? Did he ever show up in Iran? Did he ever show up in Afghanistan? No, but he's the tough talker. And so, but what's so interesting is when you look at the persona of these people that has been studied ad nauseum, it is always the same thing. They are the most fearful people in the room.